Hey, ja. Hey. I wanna say hey. Hey, ja. I wanna say hey. Hey, ja. That ain't even a song, but I can say it if I want to. Hey. Hey, y'all. Hey, everybody. How y'all doing? How's it going? Hey, I'm just so excited. Come on in. Y'all know what to do. Come on in. You're welcome here. And for those who are already here, invite somebody. You're welcome here. Come on in. Come on in. Hey, everybody, everybody, everybody. Hey, everybody, everybody, everyone. You guys are amazing. Hey, to my assistant, Pastor David James Jr. Hey, Candace. Hey, you beautiful people. Hey, thank you for saying I look amazing. Thank you. Hey, guys, it is Father's Day. Ooh, y'all pray. I'm so excited. Y'all know what to do. Come on in. Hey, Joya. Hey, Lee. I love you. Hey, everybody. Hey, Christy. Hey, Ange. Hey, I love you guys. Listen. I say it all the time. Every now and then, I gotta say it, you know, because some people be like, that take too long. I just want to get to the word. But listen, people don't have to be on your page. People don't have to say anything to you. People don't have to come and support you. That's part of the problem with the world today. We become self-entitled and we think somebody owe us something. People don't owe you anything. So I just really do celebrate all those that think it not robbery. Would y'all swipe and share? Would y'all hit those hearts? Hit those likes? Let's continue to get these numbers up, because you know now that things are opening, people are opening, you know, and we just gonna stay with God. Amen. We gonna do it. We gotta do it. I mean, y'all know what to do. Get your BYOB. Bring your own Bible. Bring your own bottle of water. Get you a notebook for what's about to be said. You know I'm gonna play some music that I do not own the rights to. Come on in. And you know I'm going to say some things that are unorthodox, but God is good. And today's Father's Day, and I want to encourage the fathers. But overall, I just want to get down to the get down, and we're going to live in the truth. We are a passion for the truth, church. And the Bible says that we shall know the truth, and the truth shall make us free. The Bible also says, stand in the liberty which Christ has made you free. Guys, buy all the Bibles you can. I don't know. I just need to make that public announcement. For Mother's Day, ask for a Bible. For your birthday, ask for a Bible. For Christmas, ask for a Bible. You going to the bookstore, buy your Bible. In California, they're trying to vote to get rid of Bibles. I don't understand why, if they don't believe in it, just call it a fiction book like Harry Potter. But you could put Harry Potter in the school curriculum, but you're going to try to take Bibles out of the law. Get your life. But you guys do what we got to do to write our Senate and get it done. The Bible said it would be so. I'm telling you, but let's go. Don't go out without a fight. Do all you can to get you some Bibles to have in your house that you can put them in your heart, that we don't sin against God. I'm trying to tell you, but hey! Happy Father's Day to all the fathers. Hey, Josua, Giorgio, COO. I love you guys, Ayana. Hey, guys, y'all say hi to one another. Let's break the back of segregation. Let's break the back of what society is trying to say, that it's me, my four, and no more. Let's not make excuses. Let's not play the blame game. And let's not ignore stuff like it doesn't happen. Okay? Let's take responsibility and accountability. Some stuff is my fault. Some stuff, blame me. Woo! Gosh, are we ready for that conversation? Some stuff is my fault. Some stuff, blame me. A lot of people don't want to say that. A lot of people don't want to have that conversation. A lot of people don't want to be that. But it's time for us to own our stuff. And even with society today, we want somebody to be at fault. But some of this stuff, if it's meant to be, it's up to me. I love y'all guys. We gonna play. Hey, Jada. Guys, we getting ready to play some music that I do not own the rights to. Hey, Peterson, I love you. Hey, TD, I love you guys. Anna Rose, I don't know if I said it to you already. Shay, Prophet, but just hey, everybody. Guys, let's get into it. Let's get ready to play some music. Happy Father's Day. Happy anniversary, Damon Harrington. I love y'all. Hey, Dimples, it's been a minute. I love you. I'll be looking forward to imagining your dimples. Hey, Christine. Hey, Gianna. I love you, and I think your friend is on the line. I'm not sure, but God bless. Yes, 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 yes. Happy Father's Day to Marvin, all the way from LA, California. Jamari, I love you. Auntie, love you. Hey, guys, you guys are the bomb.com. All right? Come on in. Swipe and share. Share and swipe. You get a chance, go over to my YouTube channel. Hit that little bell. We're going to be uploading some stuff. I promise you, we're getting better. Just like fathers, we're getting better. Just like mothers, we're going to do better. Just like saints, y'all hang in there. We're going to get better. Amen. Good morning. I love you guys. Hey, my sister, cousin Renee. Hey, Lorraine. Y'all ready? I'm getting ready to play a song I do not own the rights to, but I send this out to every father, whether you have your children or not. Whatever the situation is, whatever the circumstance is, why? Because, see, it looked like something else on the outside, and people are making decisions based on what they see. Oh, my goodness, based on one chapter, but they don't know the whole story. Oh, my God. And I'm not here to get into everybody's story, but I just want to encourage the men and women. Would y'all jam with me? Y'all ready? Hey, let's go old school on them. Come on, John P. Key and Hezekiah Walker. Hey, come on, y'all. Would y'all clap with me? Hey, let's make the devil real mad. It's all right, Daddy. It's all right, fathers. It be happy. All right now. Come on, y'all. It's all right, saints. Come on. Let's praise God. Hey. Somebody needs to be encouraged. Whatever you're going through, it's going to be okay. Even when it don't look okay. Even when everything don't work out. All right. Now, come on. You're struggling with rent. You're struggling with mortgage. You can't get it right on the same page with the baby mama. Woo! You can't believe that it's all right. You can't see. You can't talk. You sick. You laying on your back. It's going to be all right. I didn't say things going to get better. You might not be totally healed, but it's going to be all right. You're going to make it, baby. You're going to make it. Would y'all do me a favor? Tell somebody you're going to make it. Marvin, you're going to make it. Jackie Wilson, you're going to make it. Patricia, you're going to make it. Hey! Apostle Dawn, you gonna make it? Come on, somebody. Let me hear you say you gonna make it. Hey! I'll make it. I'll make it. Leona, you gonna make it. Woo! I'll make it. I'll make it. Come on, fathers. I'll make it. Women, you gonna make it. Saints, let's make it. I'll make it. I'll make it. I'll make it. Come on. I'll make it. Patricia, you gonna make it, baby. I'll make it. Gosh, I don't have a hope. Woo! I'll make it. Tell your mind, I'll make it. Tell your heart, I'll make it. Tell your kids, I'll make it. All right now. take it anyhow. Hey! 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 Somebody need to tell somebody you gonna make it. Listen. Woo! Guys, you gonna make it. You hear me? And here's proof. Here's the evidence. We talked about that last week. Make sure you bring out your evidence. Pull out the proof that you're going to make it, because there was something that you went through maybe 10 years ago, 5 years ago, 3 days ago, and you didn't know how you was going to get through it. You didn't know how you was going to stop aching and being in pain. You didn't know how the thoughts was going to stop going crazy. You didn't know how depression was going to lift up off of you. You didn't know how anxiety was going to leave. You didn't know how you were going to feed your children. You didn't know how you was going to get child support. You didn't know how you was going to give child support. You didn't know how you was going to get gas to put in your car. But 10 years later, 3 days later, 24 hours later, guys, we here. God made a way. We got gas. We doing good. Oh my goodness. Every now and then, those crazy thoughts might come up, but we had some seasons where we had some clear thoughts, where the Bible said, let this mind be in you, which is also in Christ Jesus, where the Bible says, think on the things that are lovely, think on the things that are pure, think on the things that are just, think on the things that are good. Woo, I'll make it. You are going to make it. You didn't know how you was going to feed them kids and they ate. You made it. Guys, pull out your evidence that God has come through. Pull out your evidence that God has come through for you. Pull out your evidence that God is a mind regulator. Pull out your evidence that God is a heart fixer. Pull out your evidence that God is a healer. Pull out your evidence that even when it looked like it didn't work out for you in the courtroom, that God was still a judge. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Because a lot of times I told y'all before, I said, God, go before me. Let the people see you and not me. In one case, I lost. I said, Lord, how did I lose when I brought you with me? And he said, they don't like me. And because they don't like me, they didn't let you win. Oh my God. Hallelujah. We got to ask God, let this turn out in my favor. Because there's times, because you name the name of God, doesn't mean things are going to always go well with you. Oh my God. Just because you believe in God, we as Christians make it look so easy. Why? Because he gives us a peace that surpasses our understanding. And everybody don't understand how we can be like, okay, I'm making it, glory to God. And we got to stop telling that lie that it's all good. It's not all good all the time. I'll wait. It's all right. You don't have to become bitter Betty. You know what I'm saying, a negative Ned. But you can say, my future looks brighter, praise God. In everything, give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning me. It's not good when a father's fighting with the mother. It's not good when a mother don't know how she gonna pay rent. It's not good when the kids can't go to after school programs because there is no income. It's not good when you don't have the answer. It's not good when kids are teething and they have diarrhea going up their neck and they teething and they crying and they up all night. It's not the best thing when kids have night and days mixed up. It's not good when you're in love with somebody and somebody don't love you back. Don't mind me. Anywho, that kind of stuff. God, so I'm saying there's things in our lives that don't feel good. It's a little interesting. The season is ugly. You know, and sometimes people be like, oh, nobody was there for me. Yeah, but sometimes God removed people so he can be there for you. I hope I help somebody. There are times in your life, hey, Brissy, hey, there's times in your life where you think that people are not there for you, but God, they got their own stuff going on. They cannot be there for you. But that's the time where you got to learn how to lean and depend on Jesus. And you'll find out If you trust him, he will provide. Listen, you got to learn how to put your trust in Jesus. Why? Because it's not that people purposely leave you. It's God will remove people, or they going through their own stuff. And some of them can say the same thing. You not there for me. But y'all go ahead and swipe and share. Y'all go ahead, share and swipe. Tag somebody and watch God do it. I'm going to play my other song. But guess what? Fathers, you are going to make it. It's going to be all right. I promise you. I'm telling you, if you trust God, if you trust God, it's going to be all right. If you put your if you put your heart in the will of God, he's going to come through. Here's my other song, I Don't Own the Rights To. This is by Brandon Hope. And this is about God. Because some fathers have let us down because we don't know the situation, but Father. God, some of us didn't have our fathers. I didn't have my dad, my real dad, because he had a whole wife. So I'm an adulterer from adulterous relationship. But God is a good, good father. We've had some situations. How many of y'all can tell the truth that right when you got ready to break up with that joker, you got pregnant? How many have promised you that they'll be there as a father, and the minute you got pregnant, they left? I had a situation where one picked money over me. It is what it is, guys. But guess what? God came through for me. I hope he came through for him. Can't compare of love by God. Come on, you guys are loved. Open your heart and receive the love of God. He said, I'll supply all your needs, and he did just that. Guys, open your heart, open your mind. Don't treat God like your father, the way you treat your father. Treat him better. Come on. All of you, hey! Perfect in all of your ways. Come on, y'all. Perfect in all of your ways. Glory. I'm loved by you. That's who I am. That's who I am. I'm loved by you. Good Father. And I want to tell you, even though I was from an adulterous relationship, his wife kids didn't have the best relationship either. So sometimes we feel like we're missing something, but God gonna work it out for us. He gonna give us what we need. Oh, he's a good, good father. Amen. God is a good, good father. Actually, he's a good, good father. God, man, from the time of creation, when there was darkness was without form and void, and the darkness was upon the face of the deep. The Spirit of God moved. And God said, let there be light. That's a good, good father, that we could see from a dark place. And then in the darkness, he wrapped his word around and light came. Guys, when fathers learn to wrap their voice around dark places in their children's lives and dark places in their lives, things are going to begin to happen. The enemy have put a spirit of guilt on fathers. The enemy has put low confidence in fathers. The enemy have put an isolation on dads to make them feel like, well, if the mother says I'm a deadbeat, or the mother says I'm not around, I'm not around. And then they come with this lie. This is a lie, guys. I just want to tell y'all, I'm a preach, but this is a lie. When you think that your kids are going to turn 18 and look for you, and you think you're going to be able to tell them and y'all going to have a great relationship, that is not the truth. They have 18 years for someone to speak into their life and for them to look at their reality that you're not at the baseball game. You're not at the daddy-daughter dance. You're not at the soccer game. You're not at their T-ball. So when they look at their reality and be like, daddy wasn't there, they don't want to hear nothing when they're 18 of what you have to say. Fight for your rights. Go to court and get your visitation rights. Pay your child support. I don't understand why sometimes, not every time, I'm not involved. I don't want to get it. I don't understand why we crying over $12, $40. None of that can pay rent for your child to have a warm place to sleep, hot water, food, after school programs and all that. I don't care if you're paying $2,000. There's not an amount. And for all the fathers that have custody of your children, big up to you. It is not easy. And there's something that a woman has that a father doesn't have. We are nurturers by nature. So for you to get up and feel helpless and feel like you're losing, but still get up to hold your baby and think, what else can I do to make them comfortable? Big up to you. I just want to say good morning to you fathers, and happy Father's Day. This is not going to be a day where we bash the daddies. This is not going to be a day. Oh, disclosure. Mothers, today's not your day. Even if you're a single mother, even if you're raising your child alone, you just maximize Mother's Day. You're not a mother and a father. Tick, tick, boom, blink, blink. Yes, I said it. Okay, you're the best mother you can be. There's things inside of a man that you don't have. So you would just be an amazing mother. Don't go buy yourself a card. Don't call your little desperate friends and let them tell you happy Father's Day. You will never be a father, okay? That's just the way God ordained it. And so, because I find it very interesting that you want to give yourself a happy Father's Day, but yet you fight about men who turn into transsexuals or transgender and say they're not. Stop it. Let's everybody just stay in their lane. But big up to the fathers. And ladies, thank you for being on the line so we can support these dudes. If you ever want them to step up and come up, we got to do better. Amen. Happy Father's Day. I will be in Genesis chapter 16. Genesis chapter 16. Guys, I really do. My son told me I look amazing. I feel amazing. I feel beautiful, but every now and then I hope my makeup don't run because it's hot and I'm thinking it's this spandex dress and I got a fan and an AC on. So y'all just work with me, all right? As I keep moving, if I get a little shiny, don't judge me, but we're going to be all right. Okay. Genesis chapter 16. Genesis chapter 16. BYOB, bring your own Bible. Hey, Keithy Turk Van, happy Father's Day. I love you. You guys, God bless you. Genesis chapter 16. Big up to the fathers who are on this line. Genesis chapter 16. Y'all get it. It's the first book of the Bible. Get it. Pray for my son who is a single dad with custody of his two kids. Okay, we're going to stop and pray right now, Prissy. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for Prissy's son. God, it's not easy. But Lord, I know his mother is helping him and those around because it takes a village. But we pray now, God, that you strengthen him on days he want to walk out. Let him remember who's watching him. Let him remember to put some standards in place. Let him remember to put some boundaries in place. And let him remember to harmonize his life and still do some of the things that he loves so he can have a sound mind and a good heart. Help him forgive the mother. We don't know what happened. We're not here to get into that, but God, strengthen him. Oh God, let him have a free heart. God, it's his responsibility to protect and provide for his children. Encourage him. We hold his arms up in the spirit in Jesus' name. I believe we're also going to pray for Marvin. I don't know his situation in California, but let's just pray for him right now. I believe he's a single dad. I'm not sure, but let's pray. Father, we go all the way to LA because you are the sovereign God. We thank you. We pray that you strengthen his whole body from the top of his head to the sole of his feet. We pray, God, that you open up the windows of heaven and pour him out a blessing as he sows seeds, oh God, that you remind him of who you called him to be, that there is a call versus the condition that he feels like he's in right now. God, encourage him. Form operations while he is sleeping. Bless his children. Let them be grateful in the name of Jesus that they have a dad that cares. Father, in the name of Jesus, bless his finances, bless his health, even bless Gando Rokosha. He wants to relocate. He wants to move to a bigger house, to a house of his desire. God, grant him that in the name of Jesus, but give him the finances to keep it in Jesus. Ando Rokosha, we give you glory, God. Strengthen him, encourage him. Oh God, Father, and even the people that he's been thinking about to put them in categories. God, he needs the people around him that's going to speak in his life that reminds him that he is a man of valor, that will remind him of who he is in you, in Jesus' name. God, all the fathers on this line that are great, greater is he that is in them than he that is in the world. Let them learn how to trust you. Let them get on their knees and pray, God, in Jesus' name. And they say they prayed and it seemed like nothing has happened, but God, they didn't wait long enough. God, faith without works is dead. They didn't move to the place to better themselves. Strengthen them, encourage them. Remind them of the hunters that they really, really, really are, in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless the fathers. God bless the fathers who cannot see their children. God, encourage them. Let them hold on. Don't let them go numb. And God, for the fathers that have walked out of their children's lives and in another woman's bed taking care of her kids, convict them now. Now, in the name of Jesus, God, strengthen them and let them know they may have to go back and do the right thing. And when these mothers try to hold on and be angry and hold the kids hostage, saying they were never there, free their hearts, because it's not always about money. Kids understand time, in Jesus' name. Jesus. Oh, God. Guys, let's go. Let's go. Let's go. I'm feeling this father thing strong. Genesis chapter 16, and I'm going to jump right into it. Is that all right? The Bible says in Genesis 16, I'm starting at verse 1, it says, now Sarah, Abraham's wife, bare him no children, and she had a handmaiden, an Egyptian, whose name was Hagar. And Sarah said unto Abraham, who was her husband, behold, now the Lord has restrained me from bearing. I pray thee that you go into my maid. It may be that I may obtain children by her. God promised Abraham and Sarah that they will have children in their old age. And Sarah said to Abraham, now we have no children, and this is starting to frustrate me. I am barren. I, you know, a whole lot of medicines and things weren't out then. But she said, Abraham, I have a great idea. How many women pushed a man out and had a great idea? You said, I think this going to work better. Some of you said, no, I never told him he could mess with nobody else. But if you told him you could do it by yourself and you don't need nobody, that's what you did. But we ain't going to get into that. Y'all can inbox me if you want those problems. And Sarah said, my maid, who is an Egyptian, you know, she was fine. She had some melanin, yeah, and she had it going on, but she was minding her own business. She was serving Sarah like she was supposed to. And Sarah said, I got a good idea. Since the Lord has restrained me from giving you kids, watch this. This chick had the nerve to say, I pray. My heart's desire. I pray that you go into my maid, that it may be that I may obtain children by her. Watch this. Now, Abraham heard God. Abraham had a relationship with God. Abraham turned off his ear gate with God and turned on his ear gate with his wife, whom he loved. And the Bible said, and he hearkened to the voice of Sarah. Things that make you go, I've heard people say, well, you accused me of cheating, so I did it. You accused me of having kids, so I did it. You accused me of this. Listen, I don't care who accused you or what. Count up the cost and think about it. Sometimes we have children by people that we never thought of the consequences. I know some of y'all never thought y'all be arguing for 18 years. Some of y'all never thought that you would not see your children. Some of you never thought you'd be in court and somebody tell you to pay $50, $65, $108, $205, I don't care what it is, a month for your own child. I know you didn't think so. Things that make you go, watch this. Verse 3. And Sarah, Abraham's wife, took Hagar, her maid, the Egyptian, with a fine self, after Abraham had dwelt 10 years in the land of Canaan, and gave her to her husband, Abram, to be his wife. Huh? Abraham been in this land, minding his business, hearing from God. This handmaiden has been serving your family for years, and now all of a sudden you gonna give it. She's like, huh? What happened? But because I'm a slave to you, I got to do what you say. And she ain't say she wanna marry him. She didn't even say she was attracted to him. She just said, because I'm your slave, I have to do what you say. And he hearkened to his wife, and he made Hagar his wife. Y'all didn't know that, huh? Y'all didn't know Hagar was Abraham's wife. Okay, listen, verse 4. And after they got married, he went into her. Watch this. Now we're talking about covenant worship and distorted worship. When you try to do things in your own strength, now I'm talking to the saints. When we try to do stuff, I'm talking to sinners. I'm talking to everybody. When we try to do stuff in our own strength, it's distorted worship. When we got to have control over the situation and solution, it's distorted worship. When we think we know what's best instead of acknowledging God, it's distorted worship. The Bible said when Abraham and Sarah, even though it looked like even though it looked like they didn't have any children, it was covenant worship unto God because God put them together. Sarah put Hagar and Abraham together. See the difference between God and covenant worship and what you do and distorted worship? Oh my goodness. Wow. And he went into her and she conceived. Watch this. And when she saw that she had conceived, her mistress was despised in her eyes. Sarah, you big mad? This was your idea. Why you big mad? Sometimes women, we want to send a man to another woman and then we get big mad. After he done stood all he could, now we big mad. I don't need you. I don't want nothing from you. When he stopped giving, now he's a punk. He a sucker. He's a this. He's a that. He's a deadbeat. Sometimes, mute. Put that on mute. Y'all, somebody type that. Put that on mute. Somebody put that. Put that on mute. Sometimes we just need to be quiet and let God be God. Things ain't gonna work out the way. And here's my question. We are parents. We are mothers and fathers without a manual. And we do the best we can. Sometimes we use what we were raised up with. Sometimes we use what we saw on TV. Sometimes we look at what our other friends were doing or whatever the case is, and we compile it all together and we use our pain. We use what we want and we compile it all together. So if we make a mess, why do we think they won't make a mess? We need to put it on mute sometime and just let God do his thing. Because it will work out if we put it on mute. Sometimes we just keep scratching and we feel like we swimming and somebody trying to save us and we pushing their head down under the water and we don't understand. We just trying to work this out and co-parent. Why do we got a beef about what is the right thing to do? And we keep saying, oh, it's about my kid. If it's about your kid, they'll see their daddy. As long as their daddy ain't abusive and angry and not, and he need help, let him go get some help. But if it's just regular because y'all broke up and because, because people may not be a good in good relationship with you as a man or a woman. You may not be a good girlfriend. He may not be a good boyfriend. Y'all may not be good husband and wife, but that don't mean people can't be good parents. Put it on mute. Okay? Verse 5, and Sarah said unto Abram, my wrong be upon thee. I said, sleep with her and marry her. This is my doing. I realize this. I accept this. I'm wrong. Watch this. And just because I'm wrong, don't mean it don't hurt. I have given my maid unto thy bosom. And when she saw that she had conceived, I was despised in her eyes. Now you want to blame somebody. Why she despise you? Sometimes we do because now I got your baby. Now I'm your wife. I want you gone. But because you was first, there's nothing I can do about that. The Lord judged between me and thee. Watch this. 6. Now here go Abraham making excuses. Here go Abraham putting the blame, just like Adam did in the garden when God said, Adam, what are you doing? He said, this woman you gave me this fruit. Here go Abraham. But Abraham said unto Sarah, behold, thy maid is in your hands. Do to her as you please. You the head of your house. What you mean? You still listening to her? Y'all, there's times we listen to God and ourselves, huh? I told y'all this was going to be a challenging message today. Any of y'all ever do that? We go hard for God. We go hard for God. But then when our flesh start acting up, honey, we go hard for us. We go hard for us and we do what we want to do. And then when things are, here we go, here we go. Watch this mess, verse 6. But Abraham said unto Sarah, behold, thy maid is in thy hand. Do to her as you please. And when Sarah dealt hardly with Hagar, she fled from her place. Can somebody say a mess? Can somebody say a hot mess? See, it's about to get messy. It was messy at the top. It's about to get real messy. And these are things when we look at our lives and our situations, I don't know about y'all, but honey, I was raised to, you know, get a guy that was intelligent and that was rich. I did. It got messy. It got real messy. When he chose money over our daughter, it was messy. And it got real messy. Okay, I'm talking about helicopters and flying up from to the courtroom. It got real messy. Okay. Oof, it got messy. Anybody else had a mess? Things get messy. We don't understand why the fathers are not around and things can get real messy. And sometimes it's good that they gone, but the fact that they chose us and they didn't consider the consequences. Sometimes we love our kids, but things can be messy. Oh God. Okay, let me just keep going. Watch this, because here, after it gets real messy, verse 7, I ain't get a topic. What? Y'all got to remind me. I keep forgetting to give y'all the topics, okay? The topic is called, somebody typed it, it's a situation. It's a situation. Y'all got a situation. Anybody else has a situation outside of me? It's a situation. I'm even talking all the way to people who had children and the father ended up not being the father. The kid is here. It's a situation. Okay? And I really do find it interesting that fathers be acting like the women are dogs because you're not the father and you thought you were the father. What about all the women you ran up in and you didn't have kids with, but that seed spilled on the ground? I'm just saying. That's a situation. The stuff you didn't get caught doing, that's a situation. Guys, we all have situations. When somebody let me know that they got a situation, it's a situation, okay? My dad was married, that's a situation. Some of y'all, you know, you had kids by married men, and some of you had kids by older men, some of you had kids by your friend man, some of you had kids was betrayed, some of y'all had one night stands, some of y'all had, you know, you sexually, the chemistry was on fire, but you really wasn't in love. I'm talking about situation. Some of y'all had PTSD situation. Some of y'all had stuff and they holding it over your head. I'm talking about a situation. Guys, some of us have had situations. Some of us couldn't have children. Situation. Some of us had miscarriages. Situation. Some of us arguing with our baby daddies. Situations. Some of the fathers have walked off and left. Situations. And the kids are wondering, where's daddy? I want my daddy. Or when they in school and they putting pictures up and they be like, I don't have a dad. I'm talking about a situation. There are thousands and thousands, oh God, thousands of kids in foster care. I'm talking about a situation. That's what the title is. You see that? Sarah couldn't have kids. That's a situation. She involved someone else. How many times we involve our friends, people running their mouth, people, whatever's going on, our parents, our mamas, our daddies who don't think people are good enough for us, or we too good, or they too good, situations. Oh my God. And we end up having kids in this situation. And then she went to her husband and said, marry my handmaiden. That's another situation. And then after he married the handmaiden Hagar, she didn't want to be with him. She ended up having a baby. That's another situation. And now Sarah mad. That's the situation. Now you married to a man and he telling the other woman, do what you want to do with her. And now they got beef. That's the situation. So now you got a baby and a man who's taking care of your baby. This is a mess. This is a situation. Okay, let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Where am I? 7. And the angel of the Lord found her by the fountain of water in the wilderness. In the wilderness. In a lost place. The angel of the Lord found her by the stream, by the river, by the fountain. Guys, there are things in our lives that have hurt us. There are things in our lives that made us numb. There are things in our lives that have us isolated. We've seen our mothers hurting. We've seen them struggle and do it by themselves. We've seen our fathers at a distance. We've seen them close up. But guys, it have put us in a wilderness situation. It put us where things are cloudy. The trees and stuff are so close in. That's all we see in the wilderness with the wolves, the gorillas, the things that are there where we just don't connect with it. But the Bible said the angel of the Lord found her. Guys, whoever you are in your situation, the angel of the Lord is about to find you. Would y'all tell somebody that? Desiree Little, the angel of the Lord is about to find you. Gianna Young, the angel is about to find you. Tiffany, I see you. Stewart, the angel is about to find you. Oh my God. The angel of the Lord is about to find you in a dark place. The angel of the Lord is about to find you with his clutter, with his so much going on. Fathers, the angel of the Lord is about to find you. Whoo! Find you about to give up. Find you. Some of you like, yo, I'm about to rob somebody. I gotta feed my kids. No, the angel of the Lord is about to find you. Don't quit. Don't give up. Glory to God. It's gonna come. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy is coming in the morning. And guess what? I hear God right now. Men, you have not because you ask not. You don't want to seem weak if you ask for help, and you don't want to seem like you using a woman. Don't get in her pants to ask her for a favor. There are some good sisters and brothers around that's willing to help you. There are some resources that are willing to help you raise your children and be in their lives. Come on. Come on. The angel of the Lord, Shay, is about to find you. Don't quit. Kim, don't quit. There's an angel of the Lord about to find you and heal you everywhere you're hurting, everywhere you're confused, everywhere you're angry, everywhere you thought you did the right thing and everything looks wrong. The angel of the Lord, watch this, found her
a fountain of water in the wilderness by the fountain in the way of Shur. Verse 8. And he said, Hagar, Sarah's maid. I got to make sure that you. I know you, but I want you to know I'm talking directly to you. God is getting ready to call you man, call you woman by your name so you would know that it is him and he is speaking to you. He don't got it twisted. He's not talking to somebody else. He ain't make no mistake. He's getting ready to come and visit your situation. Your situation. He said, Hagar, Sarah's maid. Watch this. Whence comest thou? And whither wilt thou go? Why are you here and where are you going? There are times we are so bitter, so frustrated, male and female. And God is like, why are you in this position right here? Why are you isolated? Why are you frustrated? Why are you not talking to your father? Why are you not talking to your mother? Why are you mad at siblings that you never met that had nothing to do with being here? Why? What's going on? Why you don't want your child to know everybody else? Why? What's going on? Why? I know somebody every year she find a new sibling. Her father used to be a drug dealer. See, it comes with the territory. I don't know why we get shocked at, you know, stuff and people doing what people do. If you're a sinner, you're doing what sinners do. Come on here. These are things that we have going on. But let me just go ahead. Why are you here and where are you going? And she said, I flee from the face of Sarah. Sarah is mad at me. I can't deal with this. I'm done. Watch this. Verse 9. And the angel of the Lord said to her, return to Sarah and submit thyself unto her hands. You want me to go back to that house where that woman don't like me? You want me to call and let our kids have dates and get to know each other? You want me to call and deal with her knowing he lived there? You want me? After they dogged me, you must not know what's going on. What was he saying? He was saying, I need you to go back and make this work. Because why? I know the future. I know what's going to happen down the line. You looking at right now, you looking at how bad it hurt, how agonizing it is. You looking at the sleepless nights. You looking at the crying tears. You looking at the he don't want us, so we don't want him, huh? I said that, you know. Yes, I did. Sure did. You looking at, oh, now you want to do something. Now you want to say something. When I wanted to say something, you didn't want to say nothing. Now, 10 years later, 20 years later, oh, now you want to live in a trove? You and the boat you came in on. Bye, boy. But he said, the angel of the Lord said, wait, I need you to go make this right. I need you to make this right. Verse 10, and the angel of the Lord said unto her, watch. He began to give her a glimpse of her future. He said, watch this. The angel of the Lord said to her, verse 10, I will multiply thy seed exceedingly, this is Ishmael, that it shall not be numbered for multitude. Wow. And the angel of the Lord also said to her, behold, thou art with child and shall bear a son, and thou shalt call his name Ishmael, because the Lord has heard your affliction. Guys, watch what you name your kids. Go look up what you named your child. Oh my God. Hallelujah. But God is saying, I see your pain. I see you really didn't have nothing to do with it. I see how you got into something messy and mixed up. You didn't ask for it. You with a child, name him Ishmael. I'm going to multiply his seed. That's where the nation of Islam came. That's where Muslims came from. But this is what always gets me between Muslims and Christians. They might got different mothers, but they have the same father. Mm-hmm. And Abraham, watch this. Did you guys know that Abraham, Ishmael, when he went back, when Hagar went back to Sarah and Abraham's house, that Ishmael lived there for 13 or 14 years before Isaac came? Woo! He might not have been the promise, but because he was a seed, he was taken care of. Guys, I'm just trying to tell you guys, sometimes we might have had children by people who weren't the covenant promise, but because we are the covenant promise, they are going to be blessed. Because their father is the covenant promise, they are going to be blessed. They're going to take care of it. I'm trying to help somebody in this situation, but I just want to tell you guys, listen, there is a point in life. Oh my God, I got to get ready to go. In this situation, we have to stop avoiding problems. We have to stop avoiding them. Can I tell y'all something? Somebody, you don't have to write it here, but you need to write it on the tablets of your heart. Avoiding situations don't make them go away. Avoiding situations don't make them go away. Avoiding situations, because see, men internalize things, and sometimes they just rather not deal with it, and they throw themselves into work, they throw themselves into other things. It's not cute, and women, we always want to talk about it, and sometimes what's interesting with us talking about it is we always want to talk about it, but when they don't feel the way we feel, we get upset. Am I hitting this today? I think this sounds kind of seem like it should be a series or something, but men, express how you feel and leave it alone. You have the characteristics of Jesus Christ, not what dealt you. The Bible said we were born in sin and shaped in iniquity. It's the shaping in iniquity and being born in sin that tells you don't say anything, let it go, don't express yourself. The Bible says God and Adam walked in the cool of the day. That means they communicated. That means they had a dialogue. And so when the enemy tries to shut you up and don't want you to have a dialogue, even when you're dealing with women or even when you're dealing with your situation or even when you're dealing with your children, be available to have this conversation. It is what it is. And when you need somebody to just be quiet and listen, say that. I don't know, I'm a talker. I'm also a counselor, and I'm also blunt, so I just say what it is. But I learned that there's sometimes I just got to put it on mute and listen to the heart of someone else and why they do what they do. Come on, y'all. Somebody need to swipe and share and start a party, because this here is going to help some men and some women. But men, you can't be quiet and avoid the situation and act like it don't exist. And sometimes we say, man, I get it. You say, I ain't going to say nothing because I don't want to catch a case. I'm not going to say nothing because I just might go off. You know, I'm not going to say anything because I don't even want that smoke. I don't want those problems. I'm not going to say anything because it's not going to matter. I'm not going to say anything because she already disrespected me. Guys, listen, I want to share this with you. And then we gonna go ahead because there's a situation. And don't avoid the situation. Let's deal with it. And when things are wrong, call wrong and right, guys. Don't just do stuff and then later want to blame somebody. Just say, no, I ain't sleeping with her. No, I'm not doing that. No, I'm not leaving my kids. No, I'm not going da da da. No, I'm not going da da da. Okay? But let me tell you this situation. There was a guy, right? He doesn't know. I don't even know if he's watching me. I don't even know if he know. I never saw him again in life. But he was my husband for a day. He was my husband for a day, okay? And what that means is I was in a particular place and he was with his girlfriend, I believe, and he was going to pick up his son. And I just happened to be pulled up on the same street as them. And the girlfriend was saying, why you park here and then walk blocks or wherever to go to your baby mother house? Why I can't know where your baby mother live? And you this, and why you doing this, and why you doing that? So you know me, right? I was in my car and I just slid the window down so I could hear clearly now. The window's down. So I am, you know, looking at the situation, and he just kept walking, and she just kept going and kept going and kept going. And he turned around, you know, real smooth. He turned around, didn't look upset, didn't look anything. He came back, and you know, I was right in back of him so I could hear real good. And he said to her, listen, I'm with you, but I will never disrespect my son's mother. I would never bring another woman around my son's mother and disrespect her. She has to be okay. Because that means then my child will be okay. And if you have a problem with that, we could break up right now, today, because I will not do anything to jeopardize my love for my son and me and his mother co-parenting. So you can make that decision right now, but you will not know where she live, nor will you be involved. There ain't nothing going on. You know I'm not even in it long enough to do anything, but I'm not here to deal with that. I do everything to make you feel secure, but when it comes to my son, we're not gonna do that. I was like this. Okay, then there was another guy that this girl had stretch marks or whatever. And he was like, you look so beautiful. And she was like, oh, if I could get a tummy tuck. And he was like, why would you want a tummy tuck? Those stretch marks carry you as Mother Earth, the queen that you are. That's a beautiful thing. And if any man can't understand your stretch marks, he is an immature. He called him something else. But he was like, he's an immature dude, period. I was like, So why am I saying that? Guys, we need to grow up a little bit. We need to look at some situations for what they really are. It don't mean we want them. It doesn't mean we do anything, but we can co-parent. We can really, really try to talk and have dialogue and communication and what's the best interest of these children and get rid of some of these situations. Some of these situations are really tough. Some of them are hard, but we gotta go ahead and free ourselves. Some of us been holding things against our fathers, against our mothers, based on what we heard or based on the reality of what we saw when we were children, but we never really got the other side of the story. And I'm the kind of person, can I be transparent? I'm the kind of person where I say, you don't want us, we don't want you. I'm good. But here's the thing with people of color, all we know how to do is survive. We're gonna survive. But now it's time for us to live and just really, really start having conversations, really opening doors, really opening windows, really opening our hearts, really opening our minds, and help our children be successful adults. Okay, because with these situations that are in our homes, they're in our neighborhoods. They're in our neighborhoods, they're in our cities. They're in our cities, they're in our states. They're in our states, they're in our nations. And it's a mess. Guys, I gotta go. I love y'all. If y'all have any questions, if y'all want any help, inbox me. If it's been good to you, I hope I said something to make you think. I understand. I'm a woman. I understand. Okay? I was married. I have children. I'm divorced. I get it. So don't think for a minute that I don't know what's going on. I know every side of the fence. So if y'all want to talk, I love y'all. I love you. Hey, Ramonda, I love you. I love you guys. Guys, we can't avoid these confrontations. The angel of the Lord is coming to tap you. Would you do me a favor and share? Would you do me a favor and swipe? And if you're on this line and you're not saved, whew, today is a great day because a good, good Father loves you. And he wants to heal you everywhere you're hurting. He wants to take some of this mess and make a masterpiece. Just ask him to come into your heart. Ask him to save you. Ask him to cause conversion. Ask him to lead you to a church where they're teaching biblical principles. And guys, in this word right here, everything is not going to come out okay. Some people you blind, you're going to be blind. Some people you're a single parent, you're going to be a single parent. But God will give you a peace in the midst of it all. Huh? Some people struggle. You're going to struggle. It don't mean because you save every day is going to look like Sunday. Some stuff is going to be challenging. And that's the problem. Sometimes we be like, where's God? I fasted. I prayed. I sowed seed. I gave money. I rolled under chairs. I stopped talking to this one. And it still looks the same. And it may look that way for a long time. The woman with the issue of blood had an issue of blood for 12 years. It didn't say that's how long she bled. It just became an issue for 12 years, huh? That's a whole nother message. So I just want you guys to understand that there are things that are going on. We're gonna be okay in these situations. So you just look around in your situation and before you go run your mouth and try to fix it and think you're gonna call somebody and tell them we need to talk, pray first. Ask God to deal with you first. It may be 3 more years before you can open your mouth to that man or to that woman or to the situation. Don't just do it because you feel compelled today. Don't do it because you feel guilty today. Get on your knees. Tell God you need his help. Tell him to meet you in your wilderness by the river. River represents life. I love y'all. You guys are nobody's leftovers. God bless y'all in your situations. God bless y'all. Know that God got something great for you. The angel of the Lord, when he comes to multiply. God is about to multiply no matter what you're finding yourself in. I love you. God bless you. Shalom.